afternoon children, I hope you all are fine. Okay, in the last week we have discussed about evaporation and factors of evaporation like humidity, temperature, wind speed, all that, right? Now today we are going to study about the differences between evaporation and boiling. So after listening this class, please write the notes. Okay, evaporation is a surface phenomenon. On that day we have seen that the topmost molecules of the, if there is a bowl with water, the topmost molecules of the water are going to evaporate due to sun's heat. Then what is boiling? It is bulk phenomena. Why it is bulk phenomena? Because we heat water, and first whole of the water get heated and slowly all the vapors are going to rise. But here only surface and surface is going to evaporate. Next, natural process. Evaporation, we does not do evaporation, we do only boiling. We boil the water or we boil any liquid. The evaporation is happening due to sun's heat. So that's it's a natural process, this is a man-made process. Then occurs below boiling point at any temperature. You all know, right? Evaporation occurs at any temperature, either in summer or in winter. We know that the clothes which are washed are going to dry, or somewhere water is spilled in your home that is going to dry. So evaporation occurs, this is the main definition of evaporation. It is a process which occurs below the boiling point of it, at any temperature below the boiling point of any liquid. But boiling occurs at boiling point. Now when I say water boils at 100 degrees Celsius, mean boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. But evaporation of water occurs at 30 degrees, 40 degrees, 50 degrees, at any degrees due to sun's heat, because it is a surface phenomenon. And boiling occurs at only 100 degrees for water, because it is a bulk phenomenon. So these are the major differences for evaporation and boiling. Now, what is the use of evaporation, or why we need to study this evaporation? You all know that evaporation helps in water cycle, right? All the water in water bodies are going to evaporate, form clouds, and again they condense and come as rain. So then what else are the uses, or what is the importance of evaporation? So before listening to this, you all know that so when you feel so much of hot, or when you feel so much of headache or something, you keep oil, right? You keep oil, and what happens to your head? It feels cool. Yes, why? Because the oil got evaporated by taking out the heat from your hair or head, whatever. Next, now in the same way, water becomes cool in an earthenware pot. Kunda untundi kada na, kundalo neelu eppudu challaga ela untayi, ఎలా ఉంటాయంటే బయట సన్స్ హీట్ కుండకు తగిలి ఆ కుండలో ఉన్న పోర్స్ ఉంటాయి కదా, లైక్ ద పాట్, ద సర్ఫేస్ ఆఫ్ ద పాట్ హ్యావ్ స్మాల్ స్మాల్ పోర్స్ అనమాట. ఇన్ దట్ పోర్స్ ద వాటర్ ఈస్ కెప్ట్. నౌ వెన్ ద హీట్ ఇస్ టచింగ్ ద పాట్ ఆన్ ద సర్ఫేస్, ద పోర్స్ ఆర్ ద వాటర్ ఇన్ ద సర్ఫేస్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు ఇవాపరేట్. నౌ వెన్ ఇట్స్ గోయింగ్ టు ఇవాపరేట్ ద హీట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద పాట్ ఈస్ కంప్లీటెడ్, it's disappear because evaporation is occurring. So epudaina heat tagilinappudu ikkada chinna chinna pores untayi kada, aa pores lo water unte aa water evaporate aipothundi. Water evaporate aipongana akkada em avutundi, aa matti kunda challaga aipothundi because heat ledu kada, heat tone kada evaporation jaragali. So aa kundalo unna heat anta evaporate aipoyindi water. Okay, now same way our water becoming cool in the earthenware pot. Now our body becomes cool after sweating. You know, sweating happens when we do lot of vigorous exercise or running or so. So after sweating, why do you feel cool? Because sweat evaporates. How it evaporates? It needs heat. It removes the heat from the body and sweat will evaporate. Okay, and in the same way our washed clothes will when we kept in sun or wind, they try the water in them also evaporate, okay, by taking the heat. So this is how the evaporation causes cooling. Okay, thank you.